Everyone, open your Bibles to the book of John, chapter 19, verse 25. John, chapter 19, verse 25. And our theme today is, Woman, behold thy son. Woman, behold thy son. Let's open in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you that we have this opportunity this morning, our ability to worship you. That through the generations, beginning with Adam and Eve, you knew that man needed a woman. Lord, give us wisdom today that these be your words through this message this morning, your eternal message. That we honor our mothers on this special day that's been set aside for them. Lord, may we take every experience with our mothers or our caregivers. We have so many wonderful female figures in our lives. Lord, thank you for them. Amen. Our lesson today is about Jesus and how much he loved his mother. Mothers care for their children in every way. Whatever the situation, whatever the circumstances, a child can always depend on their mother. And so today's lesson, we look at Jesus as he is hanging and nailed to the cross. His mother Mary is there with him. Some 2,000 years later, all over the world, that name continues to be honored. But as we do these things, it's important that we recognize that we don't want to make that name an idol, but we do it in honor of Jesus' mother, Mary. Jesus honored his mother as he hung on the cross, as he neared death. We're in verse 25. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. So in Jesus' moment of crisis, who was there for him? It was the women in his life. Women can connect so empathetically with their children. on Jesus. We remember during Moses' time when Pharaoh, emperor of Egypt, ordered all the male children aged 2 years and under to be executed. And so the women of that day, even Moses' mother, took their children and put them in the river. They would sacrifice their sons themselves rather than have the soldiers come and murder them. They would throw their children in the river and the alligators would consume them. Verse 25 in the book of John, chapter 19. Mary, she is utterly grievous as she sees her son hanging on the cross.
Let's look at verse 26. This is when Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciples standing by whom he loved. He said unto his mother, "Woman, behold thy son." Now let's look at this for a moment. This is quite interesting. I'm going to read this again. He said unto his mother, "Woman, behold thy son." See, Jesus was hanging there on the cross. He was crying out to his mother. But he called her woman. It clearly states that in verse 26. He called his own mother woman. Now, why do you think he would do that? And the reason was is that people think of God as their father, but he wanted to make it clear that Mary was not the mother at this time. Can you just imagine this? Can you envision it in your mind? Jesus there on the cross. And we know that his mother was tremendously grieved seeing her son like that. She didn't want her son to be put to death. She didn't understand fully at the time what was going on after the resurrection. Naturally, she saw the purpose of her son being crucified. Now let's look at verse 27. So said he to the disciples, "Behold thy mother." And from that hour, the disciples took her unto his own home. And that was the Apostle John. And he took care of Jesus' mother from then on. If John had not taken her in, she would have been a widow, and she would have had no way to take care of herself. About 2,000 years ago, it was the culture at the time that the man worked and the woman stayed in the home. Her responsibilities were taking care of the children and the husband while he was out working. But today, culture has changed. Women have become more independent. They are part of the workforce now. But it wasn't like that 2,000 years ago. And then as a woman aged, it was either the children's responsibility or others to take care of the woman, but she did not work back then. Now, this is a really important point that I'm making regarding that Jesus cried out to his mother and called her woman. Now, naturally, we are to honor our mothers. That's correct. And scripture clearly states that children are to obey their parents, which is in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1. Look at that for a moment. Again, we'll be looking at Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1.
Sure.
Obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. And I know that we know that we are to obey our parents. But let me tell you this story for just a moment. Bear with me. When I was just a little boy, my mom, she got angry and had to discipline me. Well, she got something to spank me with. Now, it wasn't abuse or anything like that. It was shoot her son. No, she didn't do that. Because that wouldn't have solved the problem at all. She started telling him, you come out from underneath there. And the son was being very rebellious and speaking back to his mother. Now, this is a true story. She stood there and prayed to the Lord, I'm so ashamed of myself. I've been a bad mother. And she started to cry. And she was crying because she felt like she had failed to discipline her son appropriately to raise him up righteously. So she took the wooden paddle that she was going to hit herself with and started to hit herself with it because she felt like she had failed in raising her son appropriately. And the son, who was under the bed, saw what was going on and he started yelling at his mother to stop it. And he came out from underneath the bed and stood up as she was beating herself. And he said, Mother, stop it. I was the one that was wrong. I'm the one that needs to be ashamed, not you. And asked his mother to discipline him for his behavior. And after that, he became successful in his life. His behavior had changed. You know, did you hear in the news just recently, I think it was a couple of weeks ago, about a mom that shot her children out of rage? That is not the answer. You take your problems before the Lord. Ask the Lord to give you wisdom. Well, let me tell you another story. This one's also true. You like dogs? I like dogs. Anyway. This dog was doing something. I don't know exactly what. But the father of family got really mad at the dog and started chasing the dog. Now, naturally, the dog was much faster than the father was and took off. And he yelled at his dog to stop. Come back. And the dog lay down and curled his tail between his legs and came crawling back to the father. The dog was showing respect to the father. Parents must take control over the situation. Children shouldn't speak back to their parents. When a parent tells a child to come because they need to be disciplined, that's appropriate. And that's the reason why Jesus, when he was hanging there on the cross, called his own mother woman. He said, woman, behold your son. I'll never forget the song I heard a long time ago in church. There was an interpreter interpreting it. And the name of the song was Woman. loved his mother. You know, some women ask themselves, am I a bad mother? And they question what they do. Well, no one is perfect. All women make mistakes just like men do. But the important thing is if you make a mistake, learn the right way and change your ways going forward. If you really want to be an awesome mother, or maybe you don't have children, but you want to be a role model for some children, maybe your neighborhood children or in church, you could become, for example, what's called a second mom if you like. The Bible clearly says that you need to forgive. You need to forgive your mom.
Oh.
Maybe you walked through some horrific experiences with your mom. But the Bible clearly teaches us about forgiveness. You know, my mom is my mom. She's number one. No other woman could replace that. When my mom becomes old and I noticed her skin was getting wrinkled and she was getting white hair. Some are sickly. They're not my mom, but they have other children, possibly. Or I still can cherish them for being a mom. Just this morning when I shared my testimony about my mom passing away, her body had become quite swollen. Miss, my mom was watching her pass away. I was watching her until she was gone. Now, mind you, I was grievous at the time, but still there was something peaceful. And my brother, he looked over and he said, "Bruce, do you understand our mom is dying? She's not supposed to be dying, don't you get it?" my brother in my eye and I said, yes, I know her mother is dying. And naturally, I was crying. I was grieving for Patsy. Our whole family was crying. But I got up and I went over to my mom in my chair and looked down at her body. And she had a lot of bruises on her arms from the shots that the doctors and nurses had given her. But I looked at my mom's face up close, and I kissed her forehead, and I told her I love you. And I ran my hands through her hair. That was my mom. She had trained me up to be a righteous person. Now, she wasn't a Christian, and she got saved later. But I still loved her very deeply because she was my mom. And I wanted to tell her goodbye. Moms are perfect, they're only human beings. But the Bible tells us to forgive. Maybe your mom struggled with an addiction or other bad habit. But I'd like to tell one more story before we close about a friend of mine in Brazil, who's a deaf pastor. His name was Carlos, and he's the one that told me this story. It sent shivers up my arms. I couldn't believe it. But it was a true story. His mother was a prostitute. And she had prostituted herself on many occasions. He witnessed faithfully to his mom, and she accepted the Lord as her Savior. And he had a tremendous amount of deaf members in his family. Started to mature with the Lord. the light. And he begged his mom not to go out and do that. And he said, I'll get money, Mom. I'll take care of it. He did not blame his mom. He cherished his mom despite what she was doing. Carlos would start begging on the street. And he even was homeless for a time. But after he received the Lord as a Savior at the age of 13, his life totally changed.
When Carlos told me that, I could not believe the impact that his relationship with his mother had on him, that he was willing to do that, and that he lived through that. Okay, wait. I do have one more story about honoring mothers that I want to share. There was a child about 2 or 3 years old that was home with their mother in the house. And this is about Carlos. And his mother wanted to stay in his room while she went out and prostituted herself. He absolutely did not want to do that. He knew what his mother was doing. And she locked him in his room. But even as a small child, he was about 4 or 5 at the time, he yelled and yelled for his mother. He and his brother were in there banging on the door. They were just wanting out. And so they were trying to get help in any way they could. So Carlos decided, I'm going to build a fire. So he said, somebody's going to see it out the window. And so the curtains, they lit on fire. And they thought, somebody's going to come in and get us, because here we are locked in our room. We don't want our mother prostituting herself like that. So they lit the fire. Me and my brother agreed that the fire started consuming the room. It was everywhere. And they were yelling and screaming at the top of their lungs. And they were waiting for people to come and save them. There the fire was. They knew somebody would see them. But at that point, someone finally came in. It was a fireman. And they scooped up Carlos and his brother. And his brother had been burnt on the lower side of his body, his legs were so badly burned that his skin had shriveled up to where his leg had drawn up. It was so bad. They tried to correct it, but his brother always remained with a severe limp. But I want you to know that when their mother came back, she was panicked at what had happened to them. She wanted to know who had started the fire and why did this happen. And so his mother just land blasted Carlos at the age of 4 or 5 and blamed him. That's what his mother did. This same woman that Carlos helped later in life keep her from prostituting herself. It was an incredibly tragic experience. But Carlos, even through that, forgave him. He was willing later in life, as a young teen, to figure out how to support his mother so she wouldn't have to prostitute herself.
Be back home.
And his mother one day, walking, got hit by a car and died. And Carlos misses his mother desperately. But he's so grateful and so thankful that she received Jesus Christ as her Savior. And when I look at the things that he went through, I just can't even imagine how he got through his experiences and became a deaf pastor. I just can't imagine. And that just goes to show you how wonderful God is and how much the salvation of Jesus Christ can truly bring us through anything. So even when I look at the things in my life, I just, after hearing Carlos's experiences, I just see how truly blessed I am. And that God has mercy on each and every one of us.
What does that mean?
Carlos has gone through. So whatever the circumstances, Blessed Father, we look at what Jesus suffering on the cross, and his mother Mary was right there beside him, and how he honored her with his words as he hung on the cross, "Woman, behold your son." Through our own suffering, we are to honor our mothers, whatever circumstance we have traveled through. We pray for healing. We pray for God's love. And recognize that salvation is the way. And we thank you, Lord, that we have the testimonies that we have in honoring our mothers. Lord, it is today that we've set aside, because our mothers and our caregivers, whether it's our grandparents or whoever, have brought us through every circumstance. And we find peace and gratitude in the care that we received, and we honor them in